morning. How are you? I hope you all are good with your family. Dear students, in previous class we have discussed about a unique painting. Okay, here today I am going to teach a lesson, Unit 9, Adventure. What's the meaning adventure? Do you know? Yes. See here, I am unusual and exciting and daring experience. It is such a really risky activity and it is typically bold and also engaging, daring or risky activity. Typically it is very bold. Usually it is exciting and daring experience. Okay, sometimes it is risky, understanding sometimes it is very risky and undertaking physical dangers such as mountain climbing and traveling. So dear student, in this class adventure, we are discussing about adventure. That means it is called in Kannada sahasa, sahasa karya. Okay, that means unusual, exciting and daring experience. It is called adventure. Okay, so the sub poem is mountain. What's the mean mountain? Yes, we already know the meaning of mountain. It is called in Kannada parvata. So dear student, mountain is a large landform that rises above the surrounding land in a limited area, usually in a form of a peak. See here dear student, how is the mountain? The mountain look like here, look like it. So it is large, it is very large landform that rises above from our surrounding area. Tumba etharadalide, it is very high from the sea level and it is looking like a peak. Peak, that means shikara. So usually in a form of a peak, it is called mountain. Okay dear student, first before I start this class I ask some general questions. So do you know the answer? Tell me. Okay, which is the highest mountain peak in the world? Do you know? Yes, very good. Mount Everest. Mount Everest is highest mountain peak in the world and its total height is 8,848 meters height from the sea level. Okay, second one, which is the highest mountain peak in India? Yes, very good. Mountain Kanchenjunga. Kanchenjunga, this highest mountain peak in India, its total height is 8,586 meters height from the sea level. Okay dear student, so the highest mountain peak in India, Mount Kanchenjunga, its total height is 8,586 meters height from the sea level. And next one, Mount Everest is the highest mountain peak in the world, its total height is 8,848 meters. I hope dear student to understand the meaning of mountain. Again I repeat here, mountain, that means it is a large landform. Large, that means it is a big type of landform and it rises above the surrounding area. It is different, it is very high from the sea level and usually in a form of a peak. It is looking like a peak. Okay, but it is very large landform. Okay dear student, adventure, that means sahasa. So an unusual and exciting and daring experience. So sometimes it is very risky, undertaking physically dangerous such as mountain climbing, traveling, etc. So engaging in daring or risky activity, typically it is very bold. So it is called adventure. no thought of yesterday, no thought of yesterday or tomorrow. For steps rise and fall, chill in the marrow, out in biscuit wind, with soul soul, won't stop climbing more and more. Yes, look at the board. First, I introduce the new ones from this poem. Biting cold, but it's super cold. It is very cold. It is cold. So it is a biting cold. Marrow is soft thing in the center of bone. So, dear student, here it is a soft thing. It is a center of our bone. Here, here it is in marrow. Okay. Next one. Infection. Yes, we all are having some of the wounds in some time because of infection. So that is called in English sore. Soul, that means the underface of a person's feet. So dear student, is this your feet? No, this is your hand. Good. Here, underface of your feet, like the underface. The underface of your feet. This is called sore. Okay? Okay, dear student. Let's start the poem. How the friends are taking adventurous activity. Yes, we will see in this poem. Mom came. Together we walk and we know. No one knows how far is the top. To the biting cold, hands in gloves, for rocks below, feet after feet up. No thought of yesterday or tomorrow, for steps rise and fall, chill in the marrow, out in the whistling wind, with soul soul, can't stop climbing more and more. Yes, it is very easy, but it has a one of the good things. So what is the theme? Let's see in this poem. Together we walk and we know. One day some of the friends, that means a group of friends, went to climb in the mountain. They are going to trekking. They are going to climbing the mountain. No one knows how far is the top. So many numbers in the group, but don't remember. short term. Okay, it is very simple cold is there. So all are very shivering the roots. For that reason, protection from the cold, they all are wearing sweaters, mufflers, socks and hand gloves. Although chill in the marrow, that means because of the biting cold, the chill in the marrow, some of the changes in their back, that means they are shivering, okay, because of severe cold, biting cold. And out in the whistling wind, they are shivering because of the wind blowing very fastly and it is very cold. So they feel very cold and cool. For that reason, they are wearing all type of things like the sweater, mufflers, shoe and socks, and also they are wearing hand gloves. And sometimes the wind blowing very fastly is very cold because the mountain is fully covered with the snow. What's the mean snow? Yes, iceberg. Iceberg, that means hima. The mountain is fully covered with snow. It's very severe cold is there. For that reason, they are shivering, and sometimes the wind blowing very fastly, they create a chill in the marrow, the shivering in the marrow. And with soul sore, what's the mean soul sore? So the means under face of a person cold, not because of infection. For more walking, something happened in their foot. What happened? We don't know. Why it happened? We don't know. It's only because of infection. When they are climbing, some of the members fall down. Some sports are slips. So by the time the wound happened in their leg, so it's very becoming large. It's becoming large because of infection. Because there is very severe cold. So it's because of infection, their foot became wound and injurious. Can't stop. Although they can't stop climbing more and more. Yes, something happened in their foot. Although they are can't stop and they are busy, they are concentrated on their walk. What's their goal? Yes, their goal is climbing the mountain and reach the top of the mountain. So they are wearing hand gloves, shoes, socks, sweaters, mufflers, and hold a stick on their hand, and some of the important things in their bags, and wear the bag and want to climb in a group. Who went to climb the group? Yes, the friends want to climb in the mountain. They all decided and group of a friends want to climb the mountains. Okay, and they are can't stop. Even something happened in their foot, they can't stop. It's very cold is there. It's very cold, severe cold in mountain. But they can't stop. They are busy in climbing the mountain. They concentrate on their aim. What's their aim? Yes, climbing the mountain and reaching the top of the mountain is the aim. Yes, dear student, that means the theme of the mountain is you have to do your work with goodwill. You have to do your work with a goodwill. You have to move on difficulties. You have to move on difficulties. Neither it may be difficulties or easy, but you have to across it. You have to move across it and reach your goal. That's your aim. That is your aim. When you reach your aim, when you reach your goal, that's your goal. Most important goal in your life. We all are having aim in our life. Here also members trying to reach the top of the mountain. They don't care any of things. They only concentrate on climbing the mountains. Yes, dear student, you also have to goal. Finally, you will be successful in your life. Okay, dear student, I hope you understood this lesson. Next, move on to book activities. Look at your text, page number 137. Okay, read the poem. Words are given in three columns. Match them to make meaningful sentence and say them one instant for you. Example, girls wear hand gloves to keep hands warm. Okay, so next one. The first one, it is match the following. But commonly you have seen two columns. But here they have given three columns. Don't confuse, dear student. Girls wear hand gloves to keep hands warm. So second one, girls feel. What they feel? Girls feel chill in the marrow. The girls feel chill in the marrow. Okay, the girls feel chill in the marrow. And third one, girls ignore. What they ignore? Girls ignore sore. Yes, sore in the sore. They ignore sore in the sore. I have told the student, can I explain in this poem? I have told like some of the injuries they on their foot, but they are ignoring. They are busy only climbing the mountain. So here, girls ignore sore in the sole. And fourth one, girls like. What they like? Girls like to climb without stopping. The girls like to climb without stopping. They don't care anything about else. They are only busy in climbing the mountains, and they are already very busy in climbing the mountain and to reach their goal. Girls yes, rocks under the feet. Rocks under the feet. The girls tap rocks under the feet. Sixth one, girls do not. No, they don't know.
Some of the injuries happened in their home.
No. What are these? What are these? Yes, these all are what? Action words. Okay. Sometime later we will be discussing about verbs or action words. Okay. Next. Move on. Next activity. Okay, dear student, turn page number 138. Say the words aloud. Okay, first I read this aloud. You also listen it. I have a little some blender mixing all around. A little some mixture mixing of new words. I take some sounds and put them in a and turn them on. They mix all around. Get a brand new word, let's blend along. Now take some sounds and drop them right in. Out comes the sound you hear in deer, meat, smear, sheep, cheer, clear, fear, peer, hear, ear. Now take some sounds and drop them right in. Out comes the sound you hear in pair, rear, scare, bear, care, chair, share, dare, fair, glare, hair. That means, dear student, phonetic sounds are here. You will learn this concept in your higher studies. Okay, in your higher classes. Okay, dear student, just only you comprehend the pronunciation of the words only. On the basis of this, the next activity is teacher says these words, listen and put them under the right box. Okay? Yes. Small phonetic sound and double phonetic sounds words are there. First one, A column. Second one, B column. Okay? Tear. It is comes under A column. Tear. Male. It's also comes under A column. Next one, yummy early meal. It comes under B column. Okay, you bifurcation these words. Next one, pay. It comes under B column. Pay. Ear. Ear it comes under A column. Next one, deer. It's also comes under A column. Next one, fair. It also comes under B column. Fair. Next one, here. It comes under A column. Here. Next, near. It also comes under A column. Next, chair. It comes under B column. Chair. Clear. It comes under A column. And here it also comes under A column. And here it comes under B column. Okay, dear student. Single phonetic sounds and double phonetic sounds. Tear, main, ear, dear, here, near, clear, ear. These words comes under A group. Single phonetic sound. Here, double phonetic sounds like main, pay, fair, chair, a. Okay. Next one, sing and enjoy. Teacher sings these songs, listen, then open the book and sing. Okay. What is pink? A rose is pink. By the fountain is brick. What is red? A poppy is red. In it, berry red. What is blue? The sky is blue. When the clouds flow through. What is white? A sun is white. Shining in the light. What is yellow? Pears are yellow. Rich and ripe and mellow. What is green? The grass is green. With small flowers between. What is violet? Clouds are violet. In the summer, light. What is orange? Why an orange? Just an orange. Christy. 16 or 50. This rank, this rank depending upon the concept of rhyme rose and also tongue twisters. So rose is pink, white fountain spring, pink brink, red bud, blue and white light. So yellow mellow. Yes, some of the words have a rhyming words here. Green, between, and violet, twilight. So these are called rhyming words and it's give an action on their tongue. So tongue twisters. Okay, next one, playing this game. I will write on board. Wait. Played on the ice. Okay. Okay, yes, right. See here, first one. What is in first picture? Parachuting. Okay. Parachuting. You write in first column. Sports name.
Next,
remaining threes. Okay. What are more animals? Skiing on the skating. Skating. Next one, rope walking. Rope walking. Next, bungee jumping. Okay. Okay, dear friend. Where we play skating? Skating, it's played on ground. It's played on ground. Okay. Next one, rope walking. Where it is played? Rope walking. It's played on air. Rope walking. Bungee jumping is played on water. Okay. It's very simple. First one, parachuting played on air. Okay. Look at your text. Paragliding is also played on air. Water rafting, it's played on water. Rock climbing is played on the ground or on the rock. Surfing is played on water. Skiing is played on ground. Sorry, it's played on ice. Next one, skating is played on the ground. Rope walking is played on air. Bungee jumping is played on water. Okay. Yes, friend. I hope you understood it. So, next one, we will go to grammar content. Okay. Shall I have it? Yes.
Teachers to lesson.
Next, mother cooks food. Okay, dear friend, let's see the board. You will underline the words in this sentence. First one, first you know the meaning of verb. What's the meaning of verb? Verb, that means action, verb. It shows the action of the person or a thing. For example, what I doing now? Yes, I'm talking, I'm speaking, I am writing, I'm teaching. What you are doing? Yes, you are listening. Some of the members playing, some of the members writing, some of the members busy turning the pages.
Hello dear student, let us start the identify of the action words in this sentence. They went to the market. He goes to bed early at night. The bird flew away. The sun sets in the west. Ramu rides a bicycle. My sister sings well. The cow gives us milk. An aeroplane flies in the air. Went, goes, flew, sets, rides, sings, gives, flies or action words. Fill in the blanks with suitable action words. The birds fly in the sky. The stars twinkle at night. Fish swims in water. The teacher teaches us English. The policeman catches thieves. The dog guards our house. The monkey climbs the tree very fast. The painter paints the house. Mother prepares tasty food. The doctor treats patients. Okay, dear student, I hope you understood this concept. So, action words, that means it's showing the action of the persons or a things. Okay, thank you.